got, I have 5 brandies for the body part. Now we'll attach these yarn grannies together. So that will be one big strand of grannies. Will do. Make a loop. Take your crochet hook out of it. Move it up a bit. Here in the chain 1 space you will attach your yarn. Like this. So. Then. Make 1 single crochet in the chain 1 space. Then. Single crochet up every stitch you will see, so that should be around 14. I've put my yarn directly underneath my work so I don't have to put it away later on. I'll sew it away. Here's the next one. Here's that little knot that I showed you before how to close it up. There's my working chain. There, one. And one. I put my strand directly aside of my work so I don't have to sew it in later as well. There and there. Now I'm at the top with a chain 1 space. There I'll make 1 single crochet. Then 14 single crochets down. I will speed up a bit. I hope that you know how to make a single crochet. I think so, otherwise you can't make this cardigan. You have to know the basics of this. Basics of crocheting. And the last one. Now I'm here. What you will do, you put your hook through the chain 1 space and pick up the other one with the right side facing you. And go through the next chain 1 space. Pull your yarn through and make your single crochet. Now, be careful, don't forget this chain here, this stitch here, otherwise you won't come out in the next row. Now you will single crochet 14, 2, 3, 4, well, I'm stuck in another thread. So, almost there, 14, the chain 1 space you make 1 single crochet and then 14 single crochets down the hill. So here and there I've got the strand again. I put it aside of my work on top exactly and crochet it together with the single crochets so you don't have to sew it in later with the needle, the tapestry needle. So now I went up here, crochet them together. I went 14 up, 1 single crochet in the chain 1 space, and I made 14 single crochets down the row. Here, the next chain 1 space, put your hook through, pick up the next one and put your hook through the next chain 1 space and pull your yarn through. Make your chain 1. And then again, don't forget this stitch here. 14 single crochets up. You will continue this until you have the last granny. In my case, 5. You have to go up and you have to go down. Well, put my yarn again, side of my work, crochet single crochets around it so that's hidden again. Here on top, 1 single crochet in the chain 1 space, 14 single crochets down the hill, etc. etc. And I will see you when I'm almost finished with the last granny number 5 is that, and then I'll show you how to finish off. So I'm in top, I will make 14 single crochets down the row. So So, almost there. One more. Then in the chain one space you will make one single crochet. Chain one, and then we go turning around and we start on the back side of this work. So, this is how it should look like in this row. It's gonna be curling a bit, but it will be fixed in the next row. Now, I've chained one and I've turned my work around and I'm facing the back side up. Now, watch. The first single crochet, the second and the third, we will double crochet them together. So, wrap your yarn around your hook, pulling through the first double single crochet, pull up, make an unfinished double crochet, go into the next, also unfinished, and in the third, unfinished. And now you finish it off. Don't make a chain one, just go directly into the next and we double crochet two together. So there's one and that's number two. Now you make 10 double crochets up the hill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, and that's number 10. Here on the chain, the single crochet that you made in the chain one, you make one double crochet, chain one, and one more double crochet. Now you make 10 double crochets down the row, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now you double crochet four together, but you think like, oh my god, I've got more than two stitches left on each granny. You would make this one, and that one, and that one. If you don't sure, if you're not sure enough, please go up to the single crochet you made in the top and count 10 back. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then you know that you have to add these two and these two together. So you skip 1, 2, 3, 4 and number 5. Those you will skip. So what we will do is make an unfinished double crochet in the first and in the second. Then skip 1, 2, 3, 4 and number 5 and go into the sixth. Make an unfinished and into the seventh. Make an unfinished and pull through. This hole will close itself up in the next rows. So please make sure that you have this. Otherwise you have a little bump here if you crochet them all together. I've done this on purpose, so it has to be a bit stretchy afterwards. Otherwise it's a shame when you make one and you can't wear it anymore. So now you make 10 double crochets up the hill. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm in the single crochet which you made in the previous row in the chain one space. There I make one double crochet, chain one, one more double crochet. Now you will repeat exactly from what you've done here. So in the top you have made your V-stitch, so double crochet, chain one, double crochet. Then you go 10 double crochets down the row and you crochet four together. In the first two, skip the five, and in the second two, those four, you'll chain double crochet together. Then you go 10 up and make a V-stitch on top. You'll repeat that up until here, and there we will meet again. So, I made my last few stitches in points, and now I'll double crochet 10 down the hill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, that's 10. Now we do the opposite on the first. We made here 3 together, 2 together and 10 up. Now you make 2 together and 3 double crochets together. So that's 1 half double crochet finished and 1 unfinished, and put them together. And now you make 3. 1 unfinished, 2nd unfinished, and here is the 3rd unfinished. And that's, now you double crochet them all together. So, chain 1 and your 2nd row is finished. This is how it should look like right now. It goes like little bumpy, up, down, up, down, up, down the hill. And then we will start with row number 3. Chain 1 and turn, double crochet 2 together, 1 and number 2. Chain up until the last, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, and here you make 2 more, 1 and 2. I prefer to make them in a chain 1 turning chain, so if you don't prefer that, please do so in the last stitch where you made your 10th double crochet. I like this because you get a nice etching. Next row. So this row and the next row is the rows that you will repeat up until the seam on your shoulders. You will double crochet 1 double crochet in each another stitch up until the last 2. So it's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Last 2 double crochet together, 1 and number 2. Chain 1 and turn your work around. I will do it one more time with you so that you're sure how to do it. Double crochet 2 together, that's 1, that's number 2. Then you double crochet up the hill, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I will put up here my 2 double crochets. If you don't like it, please do so here. So 1 and number 2, chain 1 and turn, double crochet 1 double crochet over the next 11 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Last 2 you will double crochet together. So that's number 2. I will chain 1 to secure it, and I will show you how it's looking like right now. How it looks like right now. So, this is one front part of the cardigan. So this is going nicely up, and this too. This point should touch your seam on your shoulder. And this is the area which your armpit will be created. So, this side you will fill up like this. On the next part, I will explain how to make the body part. So we will skip this side. We go directly up in this top. We go up, down, up, down, up. Till here. We'll make this part. And last but not least, we will skip this area for your armpit to fit in. And we'll go and finish up the last front part, the left front part. So I started with the right front part and then we end up with the left front part. It's equal to the right, but it's on mirror reflection. So you finish this one first. This point should touch your shoulder seam on your shoulder. Make sure it's not too wide because this is the base of your armpit. I finished the front part on the right side and I will go to the back part. Attach yarn here in the chain one space. So we skip this valley and up the hill and we attach your yarn in the chain one space like this. So now what says? I'm at row 5. Here you make 2 double crochets. So that's number 1, that's number 2. Then you will double crochet 10 double crochets down the row to the valley. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Now on the first and the third stitch, those two stitches you will double crochet together. So it's 2 double crochets together. Make 1 unfinished double crochet, skip that one and go directly to the next one. Unfinish and then finish them all. Now 10 double crochets up the hill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and number 10. In the chain one space you make 1 double crochet, chain 1 double crochet, and then 10 double crochets down the row. So 1 double crochet over each another 10 stitches. Where am I now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and that's number 10. Then 2 double crochets together in the first and in the third stitch, so you will skip one unfinished, skip this one and go directly to the next unfinished and then finish them all. 10 double crochets up the hill, 1, 2, and then we are coming in on the end. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And in the chain one space, you make 2 double crochets. So 1 and number 2. Chain 1 and then the first row we are done. So we made from one point to the other point. So 3 double crochets. This is the back part. This is for a size 36 up to 38 in European sizes. Chain 1 and turn. Now, what we will do is only double crochet over the next 10 stitches, and these two rows are the rows to be repeated up until the seams on the shoulder. So that's all you have to do. Double crochet, and in the middle you want to double crochet 2 together over 2 stitches, but you skip 1 in the middle. Let's see where I am right now. I think I have my 10th almost. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm already there. Haha. Lovely. First, skip 1 and the third. And you will continue like this. Up the hill, 10. In the chain 1 space you will make a V-stitch, so double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, 10 down the hill, 10 up, and here just double crochet. I made my chain 1 and I made 1 double crochet on there. Sorry, you hear some noises, but that's my child is playing. Now, you made 1 and then you make 10 double crochets down the hill. So that's number 1, number 2, number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you have in total 11 double crochets on a row. Then you will double crochet this and that one together and you skip the middle. So one unfinished, skip that one, go directly to the next and double crochet together. Now you double crochet 10 up the hill, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then in the chain 1 space you make 1 double crochet, chain 1, 1 double crochet, then 10 double crochets down the hill, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then you will double crochet the first and the third one together. One unfinished, skip that one into the next, unfinished, and double crochet together. Row 7. Chain 1 and turn, make 3 double crochets on top of the first double crochet of this row. Then double crochet 9, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Double crochet 2 together, so 1 unfinished, skip 1 into the next and double crochet together. Now 10 double crochets up the hill, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1 double crochet chain 1 and 1 double crochet in the chain 1 space. Then 10 double crochets down the row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Double crochet 2 together, so the first one unfinished, skip 1 chain stitch, sorry, into the next and together, and then double crochet 9 up the hill. So the beginning and the end of this row you will double crochet 9, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and in the last you make 3 double crochets all in that one stitch, 1, 2, and number 3. So now you have this. Row 6 and 7 it will keep repeating. So now you make 1 double crochet on every 10 11 stitches, so you make first one double crochet and then 10 double crochets, chain 2 together, up the hill 10, V-stitch, down the hill, 2 together, up, 1 double crochet in the last. Next row you make 3 double crochets, 9 the row down, 2 together, up 10, V-stitch, down 10, 2 together, 9 up, and 3 in the last. Those two you will keep repeating up until you have the same amount of rows as your front part, and then fit it. If you can touch this point here and this point here on your shoulder, there where your seam is from your shoulder, then you are done with this part and we'll go on with the next part of week 2. Good luck! So, I finished my back part. I've got here 10 rows, so I made here also 10 rows. Now we'll start with the left front part of this lovely, lovely Boho Ibiza cardigan. I made already a loop on my thread and I will put my needle hook through the first stitch. This one. Not in a chain one space, but in a stitch. I will attach yarn up there. And I'll make two double crochets in the same stitch, one and number two. Then I will double crochet around this edge and I will double crochet the last two together. So let's get started. Throughout this pattern we only make double crochets or double crochets together in the front part of this cardigan and the back part of this cardigan, only on the top. The rest of the cardigan will be a mix of different kind of techniques of crocheting. So you will learn really a lot of this cardigan. Let's see how far I am right now. Let's count together. Don't count these ones. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Correct. Now you will double crochet the last two together, so you make one unfinished double crochet and the second unfinished double crochet, and those three loops you will crochet together. Chain one and turn around. A short explanation. On the other side of the front part, this one, you will make your last double crochet in the chain one turning chain. As we start up here, we don't have the turning chain on this side, so we have to add one more double crochet at the end. But I will show you when we are crocheting. So always on the outside, double crochet two together to make the edge even upwards. Then you will double crochet up all the stitches, one double crochet, a second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, eleventh, plus one extra, 12th. So, chain one and turn. One double crochet, then we count to see if we are correct. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 2 together. Yay! So, the double crochet down the row, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9, 10, and 2 together, 1 and 2, chain 1 and turn, two together, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 double crochets, plus two more. I will show you these two together, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 double crochets, plus two more in that double crochet. In this row, you will miss on the side which you made on the other part, the chain one turning chain. So that's why I make two double crochets in here. Then you will double crochet one up, you will turn, one in this one. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 double crochets and the last two together. These two rows, you keep repeating up until this point here is touching the seam on your shoulder. So in my case, 10 rows. I'll make 10 rows up here. Then all the parts are similar to each other. And then we will sew it up together. So, good luck. Make this front part also. Make sure it goes up. And not like that one, because then you're double crocheting two together on this side. It should always be on this side. So, finish this part and we will start up with filling up these parts and sew them together to make a body. Good luck. Okay, let's start with filling up this corner here. Take the right side facing you. You attach your yarn in the right corner. Like this. So, this side we will continue like two double crochets together, but here we have to go like this. So, first of all, two double crochets together. That's one, and that's number two. Then, double crochet up, one, it's number two, three, four, five, six, and number seven, and the last three you will double crochet together. So that's one, two unfinished double crochets, and a third unfinished double crochet. Then make them together. Chain one and turn. Again, three double crochets together. So one unfinished, second unfinished, third unfinished. Make them together. You see, it's already starting to go up like this. It should not be a really rectangular, straight corner, but a little bit bumpy. That's to make sure that there's not too many tension on the seam in the shoulder. Then you go with the double crochets up until the last two. One, two, three, and four. Last two double crochets together, so that's one, and that's number two. Yes, chain one and turn. One, two, three, four, five, six double crochets left. Then you will do one, two double crochets together, one double crochet. Three double crochets together, one, two, and three, and double crochet them together. This is one corner. So you will cut off your yarn. I will make two single crochets, cut the yarn off, pull and move those two knots up to your work. I will show you. This is how it looks like. This makes sure that there's not too much tension on the seam on the shoulders. Please do like this. You repeat this on the other front part. And then we start directly with the back part filling up. You will skip this. You will attach the yarn in that corner over there. I have two pieces to fill up. So we start with this one and then that one. So, Attach your yarn on the right side on the top on the first double crochet here. And we start directly with 3 double crochets together. So that's in the same space where you attach your yarn, you make 1 unfinished double crochet, second stitch, 1 unfinished double crochet, and in the third stitch, 1 unfinished double crochet, and make them together. Now double crochet up until the valley. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and number 7. So that's equal to the front part, which you had here, also 7 down the row. Double crochet 2 together, that's 1 unfinished double crochet, skip 1 stitch, and into the next double crochet you make 1 unfinished double crochet, you have 3 loops in your hook, and double crochet them together. Now 7 double crochets up the hill, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 double crochets, and now you've got 3 double crochets left. You don't work in this chain 1 stitch. So the last 3 double crochets, so 3 stitches, you will double crochet together. So that's the first unfinished double crochet, second unfinished double crochet, and the third unfinished double crochet. 4 loops on the hook, chain them together, make them together, and chain 1. Turn your work. We'll start directly with 3 double crochets together. So in the first, 1 unfinished double crochet, in the second, 1 unfinished double crochet, and in the third, 1 unfinished double crochet. Double crochet them together. Then you go down the row with double crochets up until you're in the valley again. 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's equal to the front part. It's also 4 double crochets. Double crochet 2 together, that's 1 unfinished, skip 1 stitch, and in the second one, next one, you make 1 unfinished double crochet, 3 loops in the hook, and together. Now you go the same amount of double crochets you made on the left side, right side, you make it on the left side, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the last 3 stitches you will double crochet together. So that's 1 unfinished double crochet, that's the second unfinished double crochet, and that's the third unfinished double crochet. And make them together. Chain 1 and turn. Directly we will start off with 3 double crochets together. So that's 1 unfinished double crochet, 2 unfinished double crochets, and 3 unfinished double crochets, 4 loops in the hook, and pull through. Make 1 double crochet, and then 2 double crochets together. So that's the first double crochet unfinished, skip 1 stitch, into the next, 1 unfinished double crochet. You have 3 loops in the hook, and pull through. Make 1 double crochet, and then 3 double crochets together. So 1 unfinished, 2nd unfinished, and the 3rd unfinished. 4 loops on the hook, pull through. And cut off your yarn. That's the first fill up in the back part. You will repeat that on this side. And then we will finish off with this one. Good luck. Let's start off with the left front part. You attach your yarn in the last double crochet, but you will skip that one. So make 3 double crochets together over the next 3 stitches. 3 double crochet together. Then you make one stitch in and one double crochet in the next 7 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then double crochet 2 together. 1 and 2. Chain 1 and turn. So, 2 double crochets together, 1 and 2, then you double crochet up the heel until you have 3 stitches left, 2, 3, and 4, you've got 1, 2, 3 stitches left, 1, 2, and 3 stitches, double crochet together, ta-sa. Chain 1, turn your work, chain 3, double crochet 3 together, 1, 2, and 3, double crochet 1, and double crochet 2 together, 1 and 2. Cut off the yarn, and you are finished with the front and the back and the front part. We'll show you how it looks like. Here's the first. Here's the back part. You see, via this way, it will be a bit more stretchy. So, and here is the other front part. What we will do is take the right side to you and flip the front parts over. You will sew these parts together. Make sure that you're even with the pattern so that the V shape will go over into the next body part. So, like this. We sew these seams together and then you flip it inside out and you've got the correct sides facing you and the seam inside. Then we will go and start with part 3. We're going down the row to the bottom of the cardigan. So, this is the base of your complete cardigan. Make sure that these rows are not too long because this is gonna be the armhole. So make sure that you have not too many rows. Otherwise, in the last part, you have to make it so many rows smaller until it fits. It's just too many work and not necessary. So, I made for a regular European size 38. I made 10 rows. For my cardigan, I made 7 rows for a size 36. So, 36, 7 rows, 38, 10 rows. And yeah, well, measure, and fit it on. Fitting is so important. If you don't have it correct, it will not be as beautiful as the cardigan is in the picture. So, thumbs up. Don't forget to like my videos and subscribe to my channel to stay updated when a new video is released. So you can crochet along.